Y'all, we say that we don't judge books by their covers, but I absolutely do. Do you think that I remember the synopsis after having owned this book for 2 years? I don't think so. Ooh, okay, so axes pairing up together. Ooh, I feel like I have a theme. It is the season of fall, of rain, of storms, of reading books in your room, and it's dark and stormy outside, and you're just cozying up with your favorite cup of tea and a nice book. I mean, who doesn't love that? As you may have noticed on social media or by looking on your calendar, it is October right now. And at the end of September, but especially October, I feel like all of the book lovers are just so excited about like the fall. It's just a lovely, cozy period to be in as a book lover because you constantly want to snuggle up with a new favorite read. And I am one of those people. I love that as well. But I am maybe a little bit late with this video because this is like my fall spooky witchy TBR. So today I will be talking about 6 books that I really want to read during like the spooky season, the fall season. I'm pretty sure I won't read all of these books this fall because my life has just been crazy recently with uni. I think a lot of you guys will be able to relate, but I will definitely read these books eventually. The first recommendation that I want to give you guys is a book that I'm currently reading and that I started reading because of Book of the Month, who is the sponsor of today's video. If you didn't know already, Book of the Month is a super fast growing online book service for readers like you and I. Their mission is to promote new and emerging authors and help readers discover books that they will love. How it works is that their team vets hundreds of different books each month, and then they give readers their choice from a curated list for new and early releases. This way you can spend more time reading and less time researching. What I love about Book of the Month is that it is risk-free. You can skip any month. So if you didn't like any of the books that they give you as an option for this upcoming month, you can either skip it or they also have like an add-on feature. So they have a backlist of books that you can choose from. The ones that they send me are Apples Never Fall and The Book of Magic. I mean, the title gives me autumnal vibes, but I'm gonna leave it at that. Do you know that Book of the Month only ships to US addresses? Most of you guys know that I'm not from the US, I am Dutch, but they are sending me these books because I have quite a large US audience and I love working with them. I truly believe in their service. So thank you so much again to Book of the Month for wanting to collaborate with me and supporting my channel. And the greatest thing about Book of the Month is that they have the best price for new release hardcover fiction. And if you use my personal code, which will pop up here on the screen, you can get your first book from Book of the Month for just $9.99, which is a steal. So right now I'll be showing you the 5 books that they chose as their October picks. And the last one is the one that I'm currently reading and that I think you will enjoy as well if you like the autumnal, spooky, magical vibes. We have the thriller Everything We Didn't Say by Nicole Bart. Pushed out of her hometown after high school, a woman returns to solve the riddle of her family and a horrific crime. The Lincoln Highway is an historical fiction. In this 1950s set novel, shenanigans ensue when Emmett Watson hits the open road with 2 friends and a brother in tow. Harlem Shuffle is a literary fiction by Colson Whitehead, a riveting and willy historical heist story from a contemporary master that will leave you feeling in on the deal. And another early release is The Perishing by Natasha Deon. Set in the hazy 1930s LA, this genre-bending tale of a pioneering journalist explores shifts in time, identity, and love. And then my personal favorite pick and one that is on my spooky witchy TBR is The X-Hex by Aaron Sterling, which is a quirky, steamy rom-com about a major post-breakup hex that will put a powerful spell on you. Thank you so much again to Book of the Month for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget to use my personal code Sabine to get your first box for just $9.99. And now let's go on to my autumnal TBR. So as you saw, the first book on my autumnal magical TBR is The X-Hex by Aaron Sterling. This is actually the pen name of, what is her name again? Rachel Hawkins? Yes, it is. I feel like it's gonna be an adventurous romance with like a dash of magic. And I feel like that is exactly what I'm looking for right now. Best-selling author Rachel Hawkins, writing as Aaron Sterling, casts a spell with a spine-tingling romance full of wishes, witches, and hexes gone wrong. Never mix vodka with witchcraft. 9 years ago, Vivian Young nursed her broken heart like any young witch would. Vodka, weepy music, bubble baths, and a curse on a horrible boyfriend. Sure, Vivian knows that she shouldn't use her magic this way, but with only an Orchard Hayride scented candle on hand, she isn't worried it will cause him anything more than a bad hair day or two. That is until Reese Penhallow, descendant of the town's ancestors, breaker of hearts, and annoyingly just as gorgeous as he always was, returns to Graves Glen, Georgia. What should be a quick trip to recharge the town's ley lines and make an appearance at the annual fall fair turns disastrously wrong. With one calamity after another striking Reese, Vivi realizes her silly little ex-hex may not have been so harmless after all. Suddenly, Graves Glen is under attack from murderous wind-up toys, a pissed-off ghost, and a talking cat with some interesting things to say. Vivi and Reese have to ignore their off-the-charts chemistry to work together to save the town and find a way to break the breakup curse before it's too late. I do think that this is an adult romance because I believe at the beginning of the story our main character, she says that she's 19, so 9 years into the future makes her 28, and there's gonna be like a hot steamy romance in here, I think, plus witchcraft, spells, curses. It sounds absolutely perfect and a nice casual fun read that I am in desperate need of. If I'm looking at all the books that I'm gonna recommend to you, they all have lots of magic. Maybe they are in like a forest setting, but also they could be very paranormal. Okay, I'm looking forward to it so much. Let's start with this one, which is Uprooted by Naomi Novik. This is, I feel like, kind of a BookTube classic. It has been out for a little while, I think. Okay, it has been published in 2015, so it has been on the market for a little bit. Our main character, Anishka is I think her name, she lives in a village where there is like this ageless wizard called the Dragon, and like the whole town kind of relies on this sorcerer to protect them basically from the forest. However, he will only help the town in exchange for an incredible sacrifice, namely taking in a young woman from the village for 10 years. And she has to leave behind her life completely. Our main character is really scared that her best friend will be taken by this wizard, but it's actually not the best friend he is coming for. And that's basically all I know. I've heard it's quite like a slow fantasy. Sometimes I'm in the mood for that. Hopefully there is also like an audiobook for this one, because then I know that I will fly through this book. Probably. And just like the enchanted forest setting sounds amazing. Another enchanted forest setting, because why not? It's called The Forest of Moon and Sword by Amy Raphael. This book was immediately put on my TBR when Jody from Vanilla Moon talked about this book at the beginning of 2021, I think, on her channel. She loved it so much and she made me super enthusiastic. So Art loves only three things: her mother, her horse, and her sword. So when her mother is taken one cloudless night, accused of witchcraft, Art mounts her horse and chases after her. As she journeys through the wild forests of Scotland and England, she will use her mother's herbal recipe book and natural magic to guide her. But will she spot the signs from the omens? Can she reach her mother in time? I also love that trying to find a missing person theme in a book. And again, enchanted forest, natural magic. And I really adore the setting of like Scotland and England. I feel like Edinburgh, if I'm saying that correctly, that town in Scotland. Oh my gosh, I absolutely need to visit that place. I know that Ashley from A Frolic Through Fiction is living there right now, and I'm just incredibly jealous of all of the pictures and like TikToks that she's making. If you want autumnal content at its peak, at its finest, you absolutely need to give Ashley a follow. Oh my gosh, her content is so satisfying. And I feel like maybe Ashley's content and vibe will be translated into this book as well. But I also feel like this book, yes, it is set in 1647, so a historical fantasy middle grade. I mean, doesn't that sound just perfect? Let's go a little bit in a different route, shall we? So this is a paranormal fantasy romance, I think. I'm so bad with these genres, so don't take my word for it. This is The Diviners by Libba Bray. I think that this is the first book in a quartet. This also has a super nice historical setting in the 1920s New York. Evie O'Neill has been exiled from her boring old hometown and shipped off to the bustling streets of New York City. And she is positively ecstatic. I don't know what that word means. But okay, the only catch is that she has to live with her Uncle Will and his unhealthy obsession with the occult. Evie worries he'll discover her darkest secret, a supernatural power that has only brought her trouble so far. But when the police find a murdered girl branded with a cryptic symbol and Will is called to the scene, Evie realizes she could help catch a killer. Love me a good murder mystery. And to be honest, I don't have a lot of murder mysteries on this list, so I love that this book has that element in it as well. As she jumps headlong into a dance with a murderer, other stories unfold in the city that never sleeps. A young man named Memphis is caught between two roles. A chorus? Oh my gosh, English. Girl named Tira is running from her past. A student named Jericho, I'm so sorry with mispronouncing these names, hides a shocking secret. And unknown to all, something dark and evil has awakened. Dark and evil? Give it all to me. I really want to know if some of you have read this series, because maybe you know that about me. I'm really bad at finishing series. I do like starting them, but then it's just like so daunting to see all of these big books, because this one is like 550 pages going to 600. And I know that the other books in this series are pretty damn long as well. And I have heard mixed opinions about, I think, book 3 and 4. So I need your opinion. Tell me if it's any good. Okay, two very exciting books for last. This is another middle grade one, and Gavin from How to Train Your Gavin keeps talking about this book. He is obsessed with this, and that is A Pinch of Magic. I think Ashley actually also really liked this one, by Michelle Harrison. It has a super short synopsis on the back, and I mean, the cover looks just amazing. Middle grade books always have the best covers. On the back, it says, three sisters trapped by an ancient curse. Curses. So good. Three magical objects with the power to change their fate. Will they be enough to break the curse, or will they lead the sisters even deeper into danger? I cannot find more of like a detailed synopsis, because it still seems very vague. Like, what is this actually about? Maybe that's all we should know. Perhaps that is why the synopsis is so short. I have no clue. This is, I believe, a trilogy as well, and I think the last book actually came out very, very recently. And the last book that I have on this TBR is These Witches Don't Burn by Isabel Sterling. Y'all, we say that we don't judge books by their covers, but I absolutely do. And people who say that they don't, I feel like they are lying. I'm so sorry that I keep on reading like the synopses of these books from like the dust jacket, but they are just so long. And do you think that I remember the synopsis after having owned this book for 2 years? I don't think so. I'm pretty sure that this is an LGBTQ urban fantasy, and a lot of my friends have actually read this one and loved it. There's also a sequel out. I believe that one is maybe a little less loved. Let's first talk about the synopsis of this one. Hannah's a witch, but not the kind you're thinking of. She's the real deal, an elemental with the power to control fire, earth, water, and air. But even though she lives in Salem, Massachusetts, her magic is a secret she has to keep to herself. If she's ever caught using it in front of a reg, read non-witch, she could lose it for good. So Hannah spends most of her time avoiding her ex-girlfriend and fellow elemental witch, Veronica, hanging out with her best friend and working at the fly-by-night cauldron, selling candles and crystals to tourists, goths, and local Wiccans. I don't know what Wiccans are. I don't know if I should. But dealing with her ex is the least of Hannah's concerns when a terrifying blood ritual interrupts the end of school year bonfire. Evidence of dark magic begins to appear all over Salem, and Hannah's sure it's the work of a deadly blood witch. The issue is, her coven is less than convinced, forcing Hannah to team up with the last person she wants to see, Veronica. Ooh, okay, so axes pairing up together. Ooh, I feel like I have a theme, because the X-Hex kind of has that too, I think. While the pair attempt to smoke out the blood witch at a house party, Hannah meets Morgan, a cute new ballerina in town. But trying to date amid a supernatural crisis is easier said than done, especially when the attacks on Salem's witches become deadlier by the day. But it sounds like there's going to be a lot of tension between our main characters and like the side characters and the exes and the one that she currently perhaps wants to date, but then also the magic, a curse, creepy ritual. It sounds perfect. I feel like the books that are on my TBR all have kind of like the same vibes, and I'm just here for it right now, honestly. Let me know in the comments down below if any of these books sound intriguing to you. Perhaps you have read them as well. Then let me know your thoughts and opinions, because the more opinions or recommendations that I get, the more likely I am to pick them up. And again, don't forget to check out Book of the Month and use my personal code to get your first box for just $9.99. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking somewhere here on the screen or in the button down below, and hopefully I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!